Assalamu alaikum students. I hope all of you are fine and safe. In a previous class, we discussed about indifference curve and indifference curve map. What is indifference curve? Indifference curve shows different combinations of two goods consumed by a consumer that provide equal level of satisfaction. So you know, on this curve, there are unlimited combinations and each combination shows combination of two goods, X and Y, that a consumer is consuming. And this each combination provides certain level of satisfaction. And any point on this indifference curve shows that satisfaction is same. So on this point and on this point, satisfaction is same. Either consumer consumes this combination showing X1 and Y1 combination, or if consumer is consuming this combination, this point on indifference curve that shows Y2 and X2 combination, satisfaction is same on these two points. Similarly, as there are unlimited combination, each combination shows equal level of satisfaction to the consumer. Indifference curve has certain properties. Indifference curves are negatively sloped, that is due to law of decreasing marginal rate of substitution. Indifference curve is convex from origin. We will be talking about this, why we consider indifference curve to be convex from origin. Indifference curve don't intersect each other. If we take more than one indifference curve don't intersect each other. Why this property is necessary, we will be talking soon about this. Similarly, indifference curve can't be a thick line. Indifference curve don't touch any axis. These are certain properties you people know from your earlier two courses in microeconomics. And then we talk about indifference curve map. As consumers consume different bundles and each bundle shows different level of satisfaction. So in order to show graphically the utility gained from different bundles, we draw indifference curve map that shows that higher indifference curve show higher level of satisfaction. And when we move from left to right, there is increasing utility. So U3 indifference curve has more utility than U2, and U2 indifference curve has higher level of satisfaction than U1. If both we draw another indifference curve above U3, that indifference curve, suppose U4, will have more satisfaction than U3. Please note one thing regarding indifference curve map. Though there is a possibility of thousands of indifference curves in indifference curve map, but any of two indifference curve don't intersect each other. All the indifference curve are drawn in such a map, in such a way that they don't intersect each other. Why this is the case? We are about to talk about this in few minutes. So this was the focus of our last time discussion. Today we extend that discussion and we will be talking about indices curves in context of indices curve map and the property of transitivity. You know from the transitivity property that states that if an individual reports that A is preferred to B and B is preferred to C, then it necessarily means that he or she must also report that A is preferred to C. When A is greater than B and B is greater than C, so it necessarily means that A is also greater than C, and this property is known as transitivity property. So when we draw indices curve map, these indices curve are drawn in such a way that they don't intersect each other. What is the problem if, for example, two indices curve intersect each other in context of indices curve map as shown in figure 3.4 on page 96. If this is the case, that two indices curve intersect each other in indices curve map, the transitivity property is violated in this case. How? The reason is, you know, higher indices curve shows higher level of satisfaction. This is one of the properties of indices curve. So if this is true, we can say that C is preferred to D because C lies on higher indices curve as compared to D. So there is more satisfaction now at point C than point D. Similarly, by the same token, we can say A is higher than B, so satisfaction is greater at point A than point B. What we are saying, satisfaction at point C is more than satisfaction at point D. Satisfaction at point A is more than satisfaction at point B. But because point B and point C lies on same indices curve, so satisfaction is equal at point B and C. Because point C and B lies on U2 indices curve. If transitivity property holds, what should be? When we say A is preferred to B and C is preferred to D, but because point B and point C lie on same indices curve, so it means same satisfaction on point B and C. So the axiom of transitivity implies that A must be preferred to D. But that can't be true because A and D are on the same indices curve and are by definition regarded as equally desirable. I repeat, A is preferred to B and C is preferred to D. And because B and C lies on same indices curve, so we can say that satisfaction at point A is greater than B and greater than C. Because if I assign number, so for example, if utility at point A is, for example, 20, this is greater than utility at point B. For example, utility at point B is 15. 20 is greater than 15. Because B and C lie on same indifference curve, so satisfaction at point C is also 15 because B is equal to C. So up till now, our conclusion is that A is preferred to B and C. So it should also be greater than point D because C has higher value of 15 and D has something lower value. So let's suppose any value less than 15. But because point A and D lie on same indifference curve, so it also means that as A has value of 20, D has also value of 20. Here, our earlier conclusion is violated. Earlier, we were saying that C is preferred to D because C lies on higher indifference curve. C shows more quantity of both X and Y. So satisfaction at point C is greater than point D, but because point D and point A both lie on same indifference curve U1, so here we are saying that A and D are equal to D. So this is how property of transitivity is violated. Another issue, why indifference curve can't intersect each other, is that if we say that U1 is higher indifference curve and U2 is lower indifference curve, so it means that satisfaction at U1 is higher than satisfaction on U2 indifference curve, but at point E, both indifference curve intersect each other. So point E lies on U1 and U2. Here again, we are forced to say that satisfaction on indifference curve U1 and U2 is equal if we talk about point E. So that is why we assume that indifference curve don't intersect each other in context of indifference curve map. Our next discussion is about convexity and balance in consumption. Why we suppose that, or why we talk about one of the basic properties of indifference curve, that indifference curve are convex from origin. If this is not the case, then any indifference curve that is not convex to origin, that violates the basic assumptions about preferences. Earlier we talked about preferred area. Preferred area means any combination that lies in this area is preferred to this combination Y star, X star. So students, we will be talking about why indifference curve are supposed to be convex from origin, and if there is any indifference curve that is not convex to region, like in this is shown in figure 3.5b. This is U1 is also in distance curve that has this shape, and here in distance curve U1 in figure 3.5a again in distance curve is this is an in distance curve. This is convex to region, but this is not. This part is not convex to region, rather it is concave to region. So we will talk about this, why the indistance curve shown in figure 3.5a satisfies the convexity property of indistance curve, and why the indistance curve shown in figure 3.5b does not fulfill the convexity property of indistance curve. You people are advised to read this section, pages 96, 97, and maybe some more before you come for next class. We will talk about this in next class. Thank you. Allah Hafiz. Thank you.